If you're applying to medical school this year, or you're just considering it for the future and you're feeling overwhelmed, I have been there and this video is for you. I am here to help you score that acceptance letter with my medical school application series. I can guarantee you that you will take something valuable away from this video. If you're new to my channel, hello, I'm Yolanda and I'm a current medical student at McMaster University in Canada. I got into both McMaster and Western medical schools on my first cycle of applying in 2024, and I came from a traditional life science background at the University of Toronto out of undergrad. I want to preface by saying that everything in this video is from my personal experience and things that I've learned on my journey, but what worked for me might not work for everyone. I will do my best to emphasize high yield tips, but please make sure to read up on a lot of different sources, collect as much information as possible, and take everything that you hear with a grain of salt. Because unfortunately, no one knows the perfect formula to get you into medical school. I will speak on only Canadian schools because I only applied to those. Please don't limit yourself to Canada. There are also amazing international schools as well that you can look into, such as Ireland, the US, or even Australia. Even every Canadian school has different deadlines, requirements, and processes, but in this video, I will give an overarching guide on applications in general. I will include advice on how to choose schools, what common mistakes to avoid, and how to make yourself stand out. Now, if you're applying to international schools, keep in mind that timelines can be drastically different from Canadian schools. A lot of the time, their deadlines are way earlier in the year, so please plan accordingly. So applications usually open in June or July, and they will be due around September to October. Keep in mind that for Dalhousie Medical School, the deadlines are usually a month or two earlier than the rest of Canada, so be sure to watch out. You will need to have taken your MCAT by August. I recommend doing it around the middle of August when you've had the summer to prepare. Some schools require you to take CASPer, and ideally you want that to be done around the same time. Interview invites will roll out around November to February depending on the school, and you can expect to do your actual interview in January to March, and you'll be receiving the final decisions in May. Now, CASPer is a situational judgment test that basically checks if you're an ethical human being who should become a doctor in the future. It will present you with difficult scenarios and you will have to answer how you would act in them in written or video format. If you haven't taken it yet, don't worry. You can still take it throughout the summer and into the fall. Some schools allow you to do it in September or October. Be sure to check each school's requirement though, because they will tell you exactly the last date that you can take it for them. You can check the dates on the official CASPer Acuity website. I suggest to get it out of the way as soon as you can, because you only need about 3 to 4 weeks to prep for it max. And I know some people who've done it in around 2 weeks, but also make sure to take it seriously because some schools will look at it competitively, such as McMaster. Don't forget that the CASPer score does not carry over like the MCAT into the following admission cycles, so you do need to take it again each time you reapply, unfortunately. I can make a separate CASPer advice video if you guys want, so let me know in the comments. So there are only 18 medical schools across Canada right now, so many people choose to apply to most or all of the schools to maximize their chances. However, it's still important to check each school's requirement to ensure that you are eligible to apply, because as you can probably tell already, the application fees are very expensive. I'll be going through a list of things you should take into consideration when selecting schools to maximize your chances and strategize your application. If you just look up Canadian med schools or even on their official websites, you'll see the admission GPAs and MCAT scores as well as acceptance rates. The brutal truth is that most applicants are way above the minimum GPAs and MCAT cutoffs, so the average scores are way better predictors of your success. Do check each school's admission criteria, because some schools, as long as you meet their cutoffs, they don't judge your MCAT scores competitively anymore. So I know that University of Alberta has made that change in recent years. You'll also notice that for University of Alberta, They have different cutoffs for in-province and out-of-province students. So even though Canadian schools don't accept international students, they have different biases towards in-province versus out-of-province students within Canada. For example, UBC declares that only up to 10% of their seats in their first year class will go to out-of-province students. This puts you at a disadvantage if you're not from BC. However, most Ontario schools do not have this bias. What I did was apply to UBC because I am from BC, and also Ontario schools, and some Alberta schools just because they are closer to home, but I really didn't expect much from them. Make sure to consider other factors such as the location and special communities or programs that you have a connection to. For example, if you live in a rural area, especially in Northern Ontario, you might consider NAWSM, which has special streams for Francophone students, rural students, and Indigenous students, for example. You might also want to consider MD-PhD programs of different schools if that's your interest. Queen's University also has a Lake Ridge Family Medicine program, which is excellent if you want to go straight into family medicine after medical school. Finally, you can also take into consideration how much weight each school places on the academic and non-academic requirements. Interviews, you can use this to strategize your application and play to your strengths and unique background. Medical schools also care about you as a human and not just as a student. They want to know that you have a life outside of medical school. Believe it or not, it will make you a better doctor in the future because you're less likely to burn out. They want to know how you interact with others, your hobbies, and your passions. You'll showcase this in the ABS or autobiographical sketch for Ontario schools, or a CV-style list or top 10 experiences for other schools. Now, when you write about your extracurriculars, here's what you should do. Reflect early. Whether you're applying this year or maybe in the future, like next year, it's critical to start synthesizing and reflecting on your experiences early, especially while you're still engaging in them. When you're engaging in your extracurriculars, whether it's volunteering or working or even taking care of your grandma, if something stands out to you, jot it down before you forget. You can note things like meaningful reflections, connections to medicine, lessons you've learned, or experiences that display your strengths. These will be very important to making your ABS stand out, and they can be pearls you talk about in your interviews and essays too. Have variety in your extracurriculars. Medical schools love well-rounded applicants. I'm sure you've heard of these by now, but make sure to read about the CanMed roles. Medical schools are looking for students that fulfill these roles. Try to have at least one activity in each category. Be concise and go straight to the relevant points. For example, OMSAS only lets you have 150 characters for each activity. That's really not a lot. Focus on the developed skills, time commitment, and lessons learned for the bulk of your descriptions and not the minute details of what you did. Anyone could take phone calls as a receptionist, but maybe you displayed great communication skills when you resolved an argument with a patient, or maybe you displayed proactivity and leadership by leading a new preventative care project in your clinic. Finally, have an overall theme across your activities. This will help the ADCOMs paint a picture of you in their head and leave a lasting impression in their minds. It will make you stand out as they read hundreds of applications a day. For example, a great theme might be advocating for marginalized communities or youth groups. A hint is think CanMeds again. For essays, you want to start early. Writing and proofreading takes so much time. I know that after writing 16 essays for Ontario schools, I never wanted to see another essay again. I find that I always improve my essays if I leave them for a while and come back to it. So what I would do is write a first draft, sleep on it for a few days, rest my brain, and then come back to look at it with a fresh pair of eyes. It would help me revise it and see what I was missing. Next, you want to answer the question directly and go straight to the point. You want to make it easy for the ADCOMs to understand your story and give you points. I've spoken with a physician who once sat on the admissions council, and basically they have a rubric that has a list of criteria they want you to hit in your essays, and they'll just check it off when you've written about it. So it will not help you to fill up your word count with a bunch of flowery language or fluff. Just go straight to the point and have a concise and clear structure. As usual, mold your answers to the CanMed roles. You can also focus on the school's specific missions or values if that's something you have a connection with, such as working with a rural community. Have concrete and personal examples. Adding stories with real people will add authenticity, color, and flavor to your writing. This is where your reflection really comes in. Finally, ask people to read your essays. Ask as many people as possible, friends, family members, physicians, mentors. Often you're so used to reading your own essay over and over that you can't really tell what needs to be changed. So having that new perspective really helps. Of course, make sure to still analyze each piece of feedback critically. I can make a detailed video on how to ace your ABS and personal essays, along with my personal examples and extracurriculars, if you guys are interested, so let me know in the comments. Most schools ask for 2 or 3 reference letters at the application stage or interview stage, so make sure to choose your referees wisely. You want to have, again, a broad variety of referees who can speak on you from different perspectives and different settings to give a comprehensive picture of your character. Check each school's requirement to see what they would accept, but ideally you want to have 1 academic referee, a professional or clinical one, and a character one or leadership-based one, or a personal one like a mentor, for example. Pick people who've known you for at least a few months who can speak on your personal and professional development. Most importantly though, pick someone who likes you and whom you have a great relationship with. Don't just go for someone with relevant titles. This will ensure that you get a genuine and solid letter. So how it works is that the schools will contact your referee by email or by phone to have a conversation with them or to have them fill out a form or a letter. For example, this is the questionnaire that will be sent from Ontario schools. A question that gets commonly asked is how and when should I ask my referees? Ideally, you want to ask them at least 2 to 3 months in advance to give them time to think and perhaps have a conversation with you. You want to prepare a draft of what you did and things to highlight, and at least a few bullet points of what you did when you worked with your referee to give them things to talk about in your reference letter. For one, it ensures you get the best letter possible that fits your story, as well as it will make their job way easier. If it's 2 weeks from the deadline and they still haven't submitted your letter, it's okay to send a polite reminder email just to make sure they haven't missed it. Be sure to send a thank you note as well afterwards. Also, a great tip they will appreciate is remind them to save the reference so that they can reuse it next year if you need to reapply. I'm going to share some other highly valuable advice that I learned on my journey and common mistakes I hear about from my peers and how to avoid them. Make a spreadsheet to track all of your deadlines in advance and necessary tasks because you want to stay organized. Each school has different expectations and you don't want to miss something. They will not accept submissions after the deadline. Do the things that you can as soon as possible. Some will only take a few minutes but save you a lot of headaches later on, like sending your MCAT scores or your transcript. Start working on your application as soon as possible. You do not want to procrastinate on this. Some components will take a lot of time, like writing your essays and extracurriculars and asking for references. Aim to submit your application at least a week in advance because you want to allow time for proofreading. And definitely, please do not submit on the last day. At that time, everyone is scrambling on the application portals and it will crash. It has happened before. Don't let that be you. And finally, never undersell yourself, guys. You have worked so hard to get here and you deserve your spot in medical school. Whatever background you come from and whatever experiences you've had, you have something unique to offer. It's just up to you to tell your story. Medical school is a marathon, not a sprint. It's okay to feel overwhelmed. Just take it one step at a time, take care of your health, and don't compare your timeline to the others. What matters is the final result. The process is tough, but it's also a great chance to learn about yourself. Don't give up. If you want it, you will get it. Remember to give it your best effort when you do apply. Give it your 110% effort, but also take care of yourself and know that there are many great options that my successful colleagues have followed, like taking a gap year or applying to international schools. You can always match back to Canada to practice later on if that's what you desire. That is it for this video. I hope that that was helpful, guys, and subscribe for more medical school application videos. I will be posting a lot more in the coming weeks, so stay tuned for those.